हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिसेस रीमा सेनगुप्ता फ्रॉम शेद विद्या मंदिर इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल वसई। दिस इज़ द रिमोट लर्निंग इनिशिएटिव टेकन बाय शेद विद्या मंदिर इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल अफिलिएटेड टू CBSE। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच हिस्ट्री फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 8, इंडिया आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस पार्ट 5, प्लानिंग फॉर डेवलपमेंट। The major objectives of the new nation were to lift India and Indians out of poverty and also to build a modern technical and industrial base. A planning commission was set up in 1950 to help in designing and executing suitable policies for economic development. The country wanted to have development with the concept of mixed economy. Now here, mixed economy means an economy where there is participation of both public and private sector for the development of the country. So, the need of the hour was that both state and the private sector would play important and complementary roles in increasing production and gathering jobs. The roles mentioned here were what has to be planned by the planning commission. In 1956, the second five-year plan was formulated. A five-year plan is a plan made by India for the next 5 years to decide what type of development it wants to achieve for itself. So, when the second five-year plan was formulated, the main focus was on the development of heavy industries such as steel and on building large dams. These sectors were kept under the control of the government. The focus on heavy industry and the effort of keeping economy under the state regulation for the next few decades was supported by many. Some people felt that the second five-year plan had not put an adequate emphasis on agriculture. Others said that primary education was not given due importance. Some people thought that it had not taken account of the environmental implications of the economic policies. Mahatma Gandhi's follower Mirabai wrote in 1949 that science and technology can earn huge income for a time, but later on, if we don't try to maintain nature's balance, then we will not be able to live a healthy and morally decent life. Soon after gaining independence, India had to decide its foreign policy also. As the decade of 1950s to 1960s saw the emergence of the Cold War between the two powers, that is the USA and the USSR. Both the countries were creating military alliances, but India had just attained independence from the colonial rule, and so had some other countries too. Therefore, Nehru, who was also the foreign minister of newly independent India, developed Free India's foreign policy in this context. Non-alignment formed the bedrock of this foreign policy. The policy stated to stay away from alliances, but to remain aloof was not the main element, as India played an important role in mediating between the American and Soviet alliances. So, now we know that after attaining independence, the Indian policymakers had to go through so many details to frame various policies for Indians, and not only this. There were huge hurdles in their path. Somehow, they managed to make what was good for the nation.